Okay, so last one, let's use a, let's bisect an angle, okay? So again, we're gonna just maybe do a couple of these and kind of like have the rest on the key, but this way we can kind of see the steps. But of course, being a video, you can always rewind it and like watch the same one again, even though each individual one was not gonna be on video. So bisecting angle means we gotta cut it in half. And so this had some pretty weird procedures on it, but they all kind of make sense in terms of cutting things in half, which you already kind of know how to do. First things first, we need good starting points. And so we need to find two points on the circle that are the same distance away from each other. And so I'm just going to use C as a template, and I'm going to draw an arc through C. Okay? So what we should notice is that on the other leg, B is not the same distance away. So we're just going to ignore B. We don't need it. Instead, we're going to come up with a new point right next to it. We'll call C prime. Okay? The purpose of this is because the next step is actually to draw a segment through the middle, going from C to C prime like this. Because that's what we're really cutting in half. It's not really possible to cut an angle in half with a compass, but it can cut a segment in half. In fact, if you back up two videos, we were cutting segments in half at a right angle, and that's actually what we're gonna replicate. So once I establish the segment, all I really have to do is perpendicularly bisect it. And so let's recall the steps here. To set on the segment, just make sure it's set more than half. And we're going to make a couple nice arcs. So we'll go below and we'll go above. Okay? And so the idea here is that if we cut the segment in half, we're really cutting the whole angle in half because the segment runs evenly through that angle. Okay? We'll learn that term isosceles a little later. Okay? So I repeat, I swing to the other side, make my two marks, and I'm looking for two intersection points, which I certainly have, one here and one here. In fact, let's call this one out here, let's see, ABC, we'll call this point D. All right, now all these should line up. So if I take, okay, so if I take my point A vertex and run it through my intersection points, they should all be in a straight line of one another, thus creating two angles. We have the upper half and we have the lower half, but we have accomplished at this point the angle bisector, because I know this angle, which I mark with two arcs, has to be congruent to the lower one. And so as a final statement, we can say angle BAD is congruent to angle CAD, because I literally just cut it in half with this particular construction. Right? So in review, it's actually not that bad once you kind of have a lot of like knowledge of constructions. We're going to find equal starting points to the vertex. That was the red step. We're then going to cut or create a segment between those two red points, C and C prime. Then we're going to use a perpendicular bisecting construction to cut that segment in half, and that's really all there is to it. So let's see it again. All right, so step one, and we need to find equal starting points. And so I'm going to take the distance from F and just copy it over to the other line. That wasn't great. Let me try that one more time. All right, so there we go. So I'm going to take F and I'm copying to the other side. And so we're going to use F prime. And so we don't even need D anymore. Like that's not even going to be something we'll use. Step two, create a segment between F and F prime, because that's what we're really cutting in half. And now we use the perpendicular bisector step. Okay, so we set our compass more in half. We're going to cut the segment in half. You can use the entire distance, by the way. Like that's actually not a big deal. We'll just end up with a point like behind it. So we're going to arc it, switch it, arc it again, looking for two intersection points. Okay, if we take all the points of the perpendicular bisector, it should line up with the vertex. Okay, so this angle is congruent to this one, point A, which means angle F, EA, is congruent to angle F prime. And we could use B here, by the way. I'm just using F prime because I already canceled B out. FEA. Okay? That's your angle bisector. And so I'm going to go ahead and draw the rest. And then we will, and that will be posted. And you have the videos and you have everything you need to practice and do really well in this test that you have at the end of the week. Okay, so please make sure you're taking advantage of all this time and all this effort and all this like material. Because you definitely want to go in this test and walk out with an A, and I know you guys totally can. So do that, and have a wonderful day.